That's a big one. I mean, you can go the grandiose way and say that, there will be no carnival without the steel pan. But I do think, as I said, it's a central piece. It's interesting that the Saturday before Carnival Monday and Tuesday, we have the panorama, which is that celebration where all of the national steel bands come together. And these bands are huge. Right? I mean, like 40, 50 persons all playing. So you can imagine the or it really is an orchestra. And so that sets the tone for Carnival. So I can't envision a Carnival without the steel pan, because where would the Carnival be without Panorama?
Right now we're just sinking the hole.
Yeah,
the process, barrel.
Yeah, basically you take a sledgehammer, you hit around in a circle, doesn't really matter, working more and more inward until ideally you get a concave shape, and then which will then groove the notes into. Yeah.
Stay tuned.
Yeah. Get this barrel, but as you can see from our first round, we actually punctured this. And one of the key things about the oil barrel when you're making a drum is you need to have consistent tension all the way through in order to reach the pitch that you're looking to attain. And if there's a puncture, it messes up the tension and it disperses it, so this is not going to work. Effectively, this drum is kaput.
Alright, so we're back. Got a new barrel this time. You know, a little change of location. We're, building outside on a nice, beautiful day. But what we learned from last time is we can't swing too hard with the hammer. So what we did, we went out and bought a smaller hammer, not the big sledgehammer that we had before. And we're, we're going at it slowly. From the outside and in, really making sure we get that concave nature on the outside of the drum. And once we get that going, then we'll start moving on the inside. But it should be a little bit longer process this time. But we're ready for it.
Like butter. Like butter.
Okay, go for it, man. You're up.
All right.
That we made in the drum, and in order to do that, we're going to have to use some power tools, which include sparks and flames. So we don't want there to be any oil in this drum when we do that. especially when we eventually get to tempering the drum to make the notes in the hot and you know.
It's Ted and Tim here. We're back in the sculpture yard. We've been yelled at Campo now 3 individual times. I guess that's partly our fault, but making a steel drum is both hard and extremely loud. We just want to tell you a little bit about what's going on. Right here, we've finished the grooving stage. We've marked the notes about as well as we can, and then we've gone through with a dull chisel, which you can see right here, to go through and to basically outline these notes. Now, unfortunately, we thought this was actually going to be the easiest part. This turned out to be the hardest part we have yet to deal with, because the metal is still very, very hard, and it's tough to make very delicate and precise lines. So
very technical work.
It's very technical, and honestly, we've never done this before, so we have no clue how this turned out. We're gonna go head over to Perry's to go pick up some fire supplies, and then we're gonna go and temper this bad boy. Let's see how it goes. Hey, Ted and Tim here again. Ted's behind the camera, obviously, but we just made our mallets using rubber stoppers we got at Perry's combined with some dowels, which are the right diameter and length as prescribed by the sheet that we've been following. We super glued them because we unfortunately don't have any screws. And we're up to our last step, which is we're actually going to fire the drum outside. We're going to temper the metal, which is hopefully going to make the pitch start to emerge from the notes that we just grooved. But unfortunately, it's raining outside. After this little rain delay, hopefully we'll get to tempering the drum. We'll hopefully be in the final stages and see how it goes. We'll see you then. Hey, Ted and Tim here. We're back. We're in the tempering phase. We're causing a fire right now. Against our better judgment, in a very public place. We got some lighter fluid, we got some firewood. Hopefully it will take so we can temper our steel drum. Let's see how it goes. Ted and Tim here with our final segment. Unfortunately, the drum, though we fired it and followed all the steps and tried our best to tune it, did not come out as well as we would have liked.
But it still came out pretty good.
Honestly, what we learned from this experience is it's pretty damn hard to make a steel pan. And it's miraculous that people were able to make them at all, let alone even came up with the idea to make them, considering that they're made out of waste.
You know, and we spent probably close to 12 to 15 hours building just this one guy. You know, obviously went through a couple of barrels, but, you know, people in Trinidad and Tobago around carnival time, the months leading up, built hundreds of these. So, you know, I thought we took a good approach at analyzing a cultural tradition in Trinidad and Tobago, and I'm very glad that we did the process.
Okay. It's been a pleasure.